not a singer.
I'm a guitar player.
My head is like a box of nerds. The grape side is the music side, which is always banging around on the guitar. The cherry side is always working on the words.
Check one, two, one, two.
But they're completely independent of one another. The new record is called Room for Squares. I'll always feel a little dopey. I'm always the guy who's always in someone's way, you know? That's not the right place to stand, you know? And
my fly is open, it's just totally disorienting me. I just have to start again.
Welcome to the real world, she said to me, condescendingly. Take a seat, take your life.
No such thing as just about the idea that you can do whatever you want to do as long as you can govern yourself. Because there's no sure ticket to anything. And why would you want to trade in what you really want to do for what the odds are in favor of?
I want to run through the halls of my high school. I want to scream at the top of my lungs. I just found out there's no such thing as a real world. Just a light who got to rise above.
Do you have scratch off lottery? Then that's it. I'm a scratch-off lottery fan.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm a high roller, too, like the $5 games.
You know what's funny about being on the road? All the different and just progressively stranger names for the local stores of, like, a large chain gas station. Oh, I'm going to Scotchman to pick up some milk. Oh, don't over there to Scotchman? Okay, we're going to go to Scotchman to make a beer run. Every one of them is different. There's a come and go, but come is spelled K-U-M. The record was recorded from, I think, October to December or January with John Alasia, who I always knew I wanted to produce my record once I talked to him. And he was one of the first people that I spoke to. And he just got it. He really understood the kind of statement that I wanted to make. Three by Five was a song that I finished right around the time that Room for Squares was being recorded. And even though it was 99% done, that 1% was figuring out the right way to play it.
Didn't have a camera by my side this time. Hoping I would see the world through both my eyes.
Just about not always trying to synthesize memories from a trip. If you'd asked me 5 years ago, would you rather take a $3,000 trip or take $1,000 in cash? I'd have been like, cash, baby, cash. Sometimes trips are better than money. No one else will ever get the same kick or the same thrill that you did, but it's the confidence that, you know, you've seen some beautiful stuff.
I think, for me, I've always tried to be the historian, but the problem in trying to be your own future historian is that you miss, you know, what's going on. Wasn't that profound? Did you guys hear that? I said your own future historian. Guys, I'm sorry, you guys have to see.
I enjoyed the show so much, honestly. I could start my day listening to John and just be, you know, be set for the rest of the day. That's awesome.
A friend of mine said, check out John Mayer. I'm like, all right, checked it out. Loved him. Check out everything else I could find online. Fantastic, outstanding, magnificent.
I drove 3 hours to see John Mayer.
And 3 hours back tonight.
John Mayer, he's amazing. His lyrics are incredible. Like, when he sings, you just feel like he's, like, talking directly to you.
I think he's an incredible musician. I love his music. I like the way he plays guitar. I think his songs are unique, and he has got an incredible voice.
John Mayer's music has gotten me through some hard times.
I have a very strong connection with my fans, because I feel like to be a fan and to come to a show means that they've gotten what I'm saying. And I say, I think I'm the only person who's nervous, or I think I'm the only person who's scared or lonely or lost. And you look out to people who are moving and singing along to a song that you wrote about being lost, it's a great way to feel like you know where you are, because everyone's with you.
My stupid mouth has got me in trouble. I said too much again.
My stupid mouth, is probably the most emotionally autobiographical song that I've ever written. Every year before school started, I said, this is the year that I'm going to go to school, and I'm going to be quiet, and I'm going to be very sort of tactful, and speak when spoken to. And I could never do it. 20 minutes into class, just ruined it, and I went, well, next year. And so that's sort of the one more thing, one more thing. I'm never speaking up again starting now.
Starting now.
People really grab onto that one because I think everybody has had that experience where they just, it's sort of, you go, you know what, I'm just not talking anymore.
Speaking up again, I'm never speaking up again.
We're going to Athens, Georgia, to do the last show of the tour, and I think it's probably going to be, on all accounts, sort of the biggest, coolest thing we've done in the last 6 weeks. So it's going to be very cool.
It's like, you know, you're on tour all the time, playing night after night. And let's say that playing music is like a handy snack. And the crackers and the shows and the cheese is your energy, right? And your willingness to get in and play. But when you have a certain number of shows, you're ratcheting off the cheese, you know? But this being the last cracker, tonight we're putting on all the cheese.
Your body is a wonderland. It's sort of, it's very, within the confines of a real loving relationship, it's very objectifying in a beautiful way, I hope, which is, I want to use your, I love your body.
And if you want love, make it.
It's just all about playtime. It's about sort of romance, but in a very sort of let's play doctor sort of way.
Take all your big plans and break them.
Be 23 and to be able to make a record and say this is how I feel at 23, want to follow me to 24 or 25 or 26, I'm proud as can be to be in that position.